Welcome to PyMOL 101 with Molecular Memory. KP here. I've done some longer freeform PyMOL tutorials in the past, but in this series, I'll take you through shorter, targeted lessons so it'll be easy to get started and find the exact videos you need. Let's begin with basic operation of the PyMOL 2 Graphical User Interface, or GUI. I'm using PyMOL 2.4.2. If you're using another version, you might notice differences. Feel free to drop your version number and observations in the comments to help out other learners. We're going to load a structure of hemoglobin from the protein databank. Let's check it out at the RCSB PDB first. Navigate to rcsb.org and type 4MQK in the search bar. On the page that comes up, notice the four differently colored parts. Hemoglobin is a tetramer, a protein made up of four separate chains. To load the biological assembly of hemoglobin in PyMOL, click the drop-down File menu and select Get PDB. Type 4MQK in the PDB ID box. Now, very important, type the number 1 into Assembly. Click Download and the structure pops up in the Structure Viewer window. We'll have a whole episode on coloring, but for now, click on Color, the C button here, in the Names panel. Choose By Chain and select the top choice. Notice the four uniquely colored chains. A faster way to load structures is to use the command line, where you can execute actions with typed codes. Type fetch, followed by the four-digit alphanumeric PDB ID. But when we do this with 4MQK, we see 8 chains. Without getting too deep, the fetch command by itself loads the structure in a way that's related to crystal structure symmetry, which will sometimes show extra stuff and sometimes display half a protein. If you really want to use the command line to load structures, I'll show a longer code on screen that'll load the biological assembly. I learned this from the PyMOL Wiki, your one-stop shop for powerful command line codes that'll help you do lots of cool stuff with PyMOL. Okay, main takeaways. Use Get PDB in the File menu to load structures and set the assembly to 1. Compare your structure to the image in the RCSB PDB to make sure it loads as expected. And visit the PyMOL Wiki to learn command line codes. Now, the whole point of using a structure viewer like PyMOL is to get a sense of the molecule in 3 dimensions. Now, PyMOL used to pretty much require a mouse, and you may still prefer to use one. But updates to the GUI have made it really easy to use PyMOL with a trackpad, and that's what I'll show in this tutorial. Rotate is left click and drag. So I'm just clicking and dragging on my trackpad to rotate here. Zoom is right click. So clicking and running 2 fingers up and down the trackpad zooms in and out. More conveniently, the pinch and spread motion also zooms. Sometimes we'll want to move the whole structure to reposition it. This is a trackpad keyboard combo. On my Mac, I can click either command or option, and then click and drag using the trackpad, and this translates the whole molecule. To recenter, click the action button, the little A here in the names panel, and select center. The first thing I do after loading a structure is show the sequence. In the drop-down menu, select display sequence. The sequence pops up giving the one-letter codes for the amino acids that make up the primary structure of the protein. This gray bar here is a scroll bar. Let's look at the whole sequence by clicking and dragging on it. Following the first chain, we find a string of O's, the oxygen atoms in water molecules, which show up as red dots in the structure viewer here. Continue scrolling and we find chain B. Notice it's colored the same as in the structure below, making it easy to identify. If we scroll further, we'll see some unique three-letter codes. HEM is the heme molecule that shows up in a stick representation in the structure viewer below. Heme enables hemoglobin to bind oxygen. We can select one of the hemes by clicking on it in the sequence here, or on the structure itself in the structure viewer. There's also CMO. These are carbon monoxide molecules bound to the oxygen binding site. They're smaller, so they're hard to see. Let's use PIMAL to focus in on one. Click on a CMO in the sequence. The letters SELE pop up in the names panel here, and this selection corresponds to whatever we have selected. Click the A button for actions and choose Zoom. It zooms in really close. I'll zoom out just a bit. Now, notice how parts of hemoglobin appear chopped off. This is because zoom applies clipping to the structure. Clipping shaves away layers of the molecule so that whatever you zoomed in on can be seen easily. Adjust the clipping by running two fingers up or down on the trackpad. Clipping can also be adjusted using the drop-down display menu. Let's rotate the molecule a bit by clicking and dragging. We can see that the carbon monoxide binds near the heme in hemoglobin. Carbon monoxide binds well to hemoglobin and can prevent oxygen binding. This is the basis for carbon monoxide poisoning. And that's today's lesson. Join me next time to learn how to save selections and use them to display different parts of the structure in different ways. Thanks for watching.